Hello, this is Thomas from TGMB. In our last video, we went through the Raspberry Pi OS and how you can get it installed on the Raspberry Pi itself. And today we're going to show you how you can get the Raspberry Pi camera connected with the Raspberry Pi itself, followed by software installation on how you can view the camera stream on your mobile, tablet, or laptop. Alright, so the first step would be to connect the camera itself using this provided ribbon cable to the CSI slot over here. Okay, so this is the slot that we need to use to connect the ribbon cable. Alright, so first step would be to shift this black clip upwards, so just pull it upwards, from the sides. And then we need to simply insert the ribbon cable in this slot. Make sure that this blue part over here is facing towards the black clip or this Ethernet port. So I'm just going to slide it in. And whilst holding the ribbon cable inside, you just need to push down the black clip. And that's it, your camera is now installed. Please note that for this project you need a 32-bit OS and not a 64-bit. Note that in our first video we have flashed a 64-bit version, so you need to reflash your SD card with a 32-bit OS. Alright, so now that we have the camera connected to the Raspberry Pi, I have booted my Raspberry Pi and I have connected to it using VNC. Subscribe if you'd like to know more how to set up VNC on your Raspberry Pi. Okay, the next step would be to test whether we have the camera connected correctly or not. Luckily, there's a library that we can use, which is called libcamera. So the first step would be to click on the terminal icon over here, and this will launch the terminal window. So what you need to do is you need to type in libcamera-hello and press enter. This should show you a preview of the camera, as you can see over there. There's also another command that you can use, and this is libcamera-jpeg. This will allow you to simply capture a photo. So I'm going to head to the desktop. So just write cd space desktop. This will change directory to your desktop. Press enter, and then we're just going to write libcamera-jpeg space 0, actually space o, test.jpeg. And as you can see, we get the preview again, and the camera will capture an image, as you can see over here. Okay. All right, so now that we're done with that, we're going to head to the software installation, which will manage our camera stream. So for that, you would need to open the browser. May I remind you that we're running a 32-bit OS version here. And we're going to search for RPI Cam. All right, so it's actually the first result that we're interested in, RPI Cam web interface. This is a web interface for the Raspberry Pi camera module. And as we can see over here, it can be used for a wide variety of applications, including surveillance, DVR recording, as well as time-lapse photography. Okay, so as you can see, there's plenty of contents that you can go through. But in this video, we're just going to go through the basic installation for the Raspberry Pi. All right, so let's proceed with the steps. So the first step would be to install Raspbian. You have already done that, and we're actually running Raspbian over here. then to attach the camera to the Raspberry Pi. We have done that as well. So the next step would be to enable the camera support. This is very important because this this software uses the legacy camera. Okay, so let's start with this step. You would need to copy the first command and paste it in your terminal. This will launch the software configuration tools, and we need to head to interface options, legacy camera, and you need to select yes. Okay, so make sure that you select yes, and then let's go to finish. I'm using tab, the tab key, to browse to the finish menu, and then you are prompted to reboot. This is a very important step. Make sure that you reboot your system, as otherwise the legacy camera will not be enabled. Okay, so the Pi has rebooted, so we're going to proceed with our installation. I'm going to open the browser again, and I'm going to load the same website, which is hosted on elinux.org. Let's scroll down a little bit just to go back to the step we left off. So we have enabled the legacy camera support. The next step would be to run. We need to run all of these commands. So let's open the terminal again, and let's start with the first one. So that would be update. This will update the packages. Then we need to run the next command, which is the dist-upgrade. This will do the actual upgrade. So I have done this before I started the video, so I don't have any updates. But you might have some updates. In that case, you just need to wait a little bit. Next, let's install Git. This is required because we need to clone the repository. We need to actually download the software on the Raspberry Pi. And that would be step 5. In my case, I'm going to change the directory to the desktop once again, as I would like this repository to be cloned on my desktop. So I'm going to copy this whole command, paste it in the terminal. And as you can see, we have a new folder over here that was generated by this command. And if we open it, we can see a bunch of files and folders. Okay, this is the actual software we're going to use. Okay, so now that we're done, we're just going to proceed to the next command, which is cd, which means change directory to that folder over here that we have downloaded. And these commands we need to skip. We don't need to execute these commands because we are not on pre-buster versions. We are actually on a version which is codenamed Bullseye, so you don't need to execute these commands. Actually, please do not execute these commands. Next, we need to carry on with the installation. So I'm just going to copy this command. Make sure that you also copy the dot at the very beginning, as it's very important that this will execute this batch file. So I'm just going to press enter, and this will usually take a while depending on the Raspberry Pi version that you have. We are greeted with a number of configuration options. I'm just going to stick with the default options. So the camera subfolder is HTML. Auto start, yes, we would like the camera to start when the OS is started. We would like to work with the Apache as server. The web port is 80, which is the default web port. No user, no password, but for security purposes, you can set these. Actually, I would recommend that you set them up. JPEG link, no. And PHP, the 7.4 version, which is fine for this task. Tab, hit enter. This will take a while, so sit back and relax. We will be back when this is done. Note that the links are in the description below. Okay, so the installation seems to be done. We are prompted with this dialog, which asks us whether we would like to start the camera or not. I'm just going to press enter. hopefully you don't get any error messages. And in fact, no news is good news, so it seems that the software is up and running. We're going to test this in the browser. So we already have a browser, the browser opened over here. We're just going to click on new, which creates a new tab. And I'm just going to head to 127.0.0.1, which refers to the local machine, and press enter. All right, so we seem to have a parse running over here. I'm just going to click on HTML. And as you can see, the camera is up and running. Awesome. Note that you can record an image, so you can simply take a capture an image. You can also record video. You can also use time-lapse recording. You can also start motion detection and so on. Of course, you can download the videos and images that you've captured. In this case, you only have one. And you can also change the camera settings. For example, the preset that I usually prefer would be the maximum view, as this will give you more, you will be able to see much more in, the stream would give you a larger view, the maximum view. You can also change the annotation text, which is this, the text that is shown up here, and much more. Okay, so now that we have finalized the software installation for the camera, the next step would be to view the camera stream on your other devices, so on your mobile phone, your tablet, or your laptop. Since the software is running on the Raspberry Pi itself and the Raspberry Pi is connected to the internet, the first step would be to get the IP address of the Raspberry Pi, as this is required in order to view the stream on other devices. So in order to check what the IP is of your Raspberry Pi, we need to head back to the terminal, and we would need to run this command ifconfig, C-O-N-F-I-G, and this will give you some text. So note that if you are connected using Wi-Fi, we're using Wi-Fi over here, you need to refer to this WLAN0. This refers to your wireless connection. And what interests you is this INET number over here. Okay, that is actually your local IP address. And this is what we need in order to configure our mobile phone. Okay, so we're going to take note of this number over here, 192.168.0.145, as we're going to use that to set it up on our phones. If you are connected using the Ethernet cable, you would need to check for that INET number in this interface, in the ETH0. Okay? Let's go ahead and install the application that will allow us to view the camera stream. So you need to head to the Play Store or to the App Store, depending on your OS, and we need to look for IP Cam Viewer. There's the pro version if you prefer, but the light one works just fine. So we're going to install the IP Cam Viewer Lite. Super, now let's open it. Let's allow it to access the file system. Then hit close, and we need to add a new camera. So we need to add a generic URL, so make sure you select the generic URL. You can add your own name over here. And as model, we're going to select generic video URL. And this is where you need to remember that IP address that we mentioned earlier. So this needs to read http://, your IP address, so that in our case was 192.168.0.145/html/cam_pic.php. We're going to write this full URL in the description below. And then you should be done. Just hit test and you should see the camera picture, just one camera picture. If you're happy with that, just hit save and you've managed to successfully install the camera stream right on your phone. So we hope that you have enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe for more. Stay tuned because we have much more for you.